Hello, beautiful Aries. Welcome to your speed shuffle and reading. Meandering pathway, go with the flow is the advice of spirit. For the best result in your love life, go with the flow. We also have hummingbird spirit. Enjoy life. You know, drink the nectar of life, my friends. And dragon power. So you're very, very much in your own power at this time, Aries. So let's look and see. So in terms of thoughts, your person wants to come towards you. They're rushing towards you. That is the honey, I'm home card. I want to get to know you, all about you. And your person is very, I would say, territorial. When I get the King of Wands, we see someone who is very charming, sexy, somebody who can flirt, but somebody who really likes to jump in. This is kind of almost the firefighter. You know, I'm going to jump into the fire. I'm going to save you. But it also is a person who is very much, this is Leo energy. We have Cancerian energy, but your person wants very much to be the man in your life. And we have the King and Queen of Wands. So Aries, here you are in your reading. Your divine partner is right here, feeling as though you are thinking of you as their divine partner. You're well matched. All that fiery energy, all that passion, really gorgeous. Okay, the Ace of Coins. Your person feels in their heart space that they want to make a commitment to you. Hierophant, very traditional. They want the traditional way of family life, of marriage, of relationship, of belief system. Whatever it is, they want to make sure that you're on the same page with them. They're in their heart space. They love you. They do feel very vulnerable with you, though. They want to make an offer. They are making an offer. That is the coin. It's like an engagement ring oftentimes when we look at offers of love. But your person wants to offer you this very traditional relationship with traditional roles and beliefs. But when we get the Moon card, that is Pisces energy, and it speaks to the fact that your person sometimes just feels as though they're lost in your relationship. They don't really understand all their feelings here. When we look at the energy, I'm going to move those over a little bit. These are their actions right here, okay? So when we look at their intentions with you, their intentions are almost like they have to stick up for themselves. They feel as though this comes through some conflict, is my opinion. They feel overwhelmed. They don't know what to say. They are rushing in to get you, but it's almost as though they don't know how to navigate the relationship once they get there. Because this person's intention is to sort of be defensive. I mean, so it does speak to the fact that I think that there's been some conflict. And with fire signs, it's pretty common. Fire sign energy. You know, you're just out there being you, doing you. But your person feels as though they have to defend themselves. So that their intention is to not say or do anything that's going to wreck the relationship, but they are defensive, but they do want to go the distance with you. So their intention is this beautiful strength card. They have the courage, they have the strength to do it. But your person feels overwhelmed sometimes. In terms of their actions towards you at this time, the overall energy of the reading was the Ten of Coins, the Hierophant card. When we look at this energy of the Ten of Coins, that is a legacy relationship, a legacy marriage. It is a marriage card, is how we think of this, as we do the Hierophant card. And it is two people working together to create an abundant, beautiful marriage. A relationship, long-term commitment. The dog here, the family dog, always represents the loyalty, the children, the fun. The sunshine is the absolute, the sun and this, the yellow in the card is how much fun the two of you have together when things are going well. Now, your person is going to throw caution to the winds. They do think that you have someone else that you could be interested in. And this is why I believe they're underwater here with this Pisces card, the Moon card. I feel as though your person is worried.
and they're not, they're, it's almost like, no, I don't want it to be true. You know, I'm just going to hold back and not say anything. So your person, the actions that they're taking right now are very much enthusiasm, passion, communication, wanting to bring the relationship back into a sweeter time. But the Three of Swords really speaks to the fact that your person, there are people in your person's life who probably are trying to sway them or talk to them about the relationship, and it does not look like it's helpful. They look very defensive. But I feel very much that this Three of Swords card is a card that tells me that they are jealous of you, that they think that you may have another love interest. So let's go ahead here and look at the clarifying cards. I'm going to use a witch's tarot. It is Halloween season. Okay, so let's look at this. Why do we have the Chariot card here? Why does your person want to rush home and say, honey, I'm home? They definitely want to live with you. The Judgment card, they've already made up their mind. Okay, so in terms of their thoughts, they've already made up their mind. They've already passed judgment. They've made that decision. We get the Two of Wands. Again, they need to reaffirm the decision that they've made. So what we see is your person wants to know. They're kind of on the lookout to see how you feel about them. We get the Six of Pentacles. They feel as though you are looking for someone who is very, you know, you're mutually giving to one another. The Six of Coins is about equal give and take, and they really want that with you. That is the, that's how they think of you. They think of you as a person who's very generous in the relationship, and they really appreciate that about you. Let's look and see what this offer is. Okay, Wheel of Fortune. When the timing is right, your person wants to make a substantial offer up to and including a ring. It, you know, offers, love offers can come in all shapes and sizes, so can gifts, but your person definitely is looking for the timing to be right. They're spinning the wheel there. They're taking their chances on you. The Four of Cups is clarifying the Hierophant card. It speaks to the fact that there's been some sort of dissatisfaction. They feel as though they're not getting from the relationship what they'd like to have. When we look at this Four of Cups, we see somebody who feels as though they've done something wrong or something is wrong. You can see the look on the little boy's face. He's looking here kind of at a father figure going, oh my God, I hope dad's going to be okay. So depending on your age, you know, the characters are just symbolic. But what we see is that you are in a state of feeling underwater. You know, it could be depression, I guess. I don't like to label stuff, but it just really shows that your person is not really feeling confident. They absolutely lack confidence, although they project a lot of confidence out. So the Emperor card, your person really, oh my goodness, Aries, that's your energy. Your person feels that no matter what they do, that you're always kind of going to be in charge, Aries. But you know, the Aries queen is accustomed to being in charge. So your person always feels like you get the last word, that you're the heavyweight, that you're kind of the boss of the relationship. And it, they just struggle with it. You know, they seem to be struggling with where they fit in the whole thing and, you know, what they want. But you're very powerful. You've got dragon power, Aries. You know what you want. You're clear about who you are. And I feel as though this person may struggle with how self-confident you are. So, you know, leave comments below, because that really helps me when I'm doing collective readings. Personal readings are easy. I can tap in to one person, but it's really helpful when I get feedback on collective readings. So the Magician card, look at this. Your person wants to manifest you. They're secretly manifesting you. They just don't want you to see it. Look at that. That's their intention, and that is what they are doing. The Seven of Pentacles, your person totally intends to invest. They've planted seeds in this relationship, and they plan on harvesting those seeds. Your person may also really like pets. You can see that cat over there going, let me help you, person of Aries. All right, so the Page of Wands, throwing caution to the winds after a period of time of not really being very progressive in the relationship. I feel like this person sort of waits around for you to set the guidelines for how things are going to go. And I don't think it's like them. Your person likes to be in charge, but they don't feel so in charge with you. All right, so we have the Seven of Wands with the Eight of Wands, Seven of Wands, Seven of Wands, Eight of Wands. Okay, so again, your person is feeling like they're just going to have to charge ahead. If they want to have you, they're going to have to stop feeling defensive and actually move in your direction of that Eight of Wands. So we also have, oh, the Chariot card again. Your person is very much coming towards you. They don't care. They don't care how uncomfortable. They don't care that this relationship is different than they've ever had before. They want you. They have their eye on you. And look at that, the Lover's card. So your person is picking you and they're hoping that you pick them. The Knight of Swords, they have a lot to say to you. Aries, you have a really beautiful, beautiful relationship here in the works. So, sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. Thanks. Bye-bye.